Let's suppose that you're trying to figure out the best places to open a chain of stores in the United States. So let's say you have a list of cities in the United States, and here I went and traced a map from the United States. I can't draw this well. I traced a map onto the tablet, and I dotted in, I think this is the 50 largest cities in the U.S. And let's say that you're trying to open a chain of stores across the United States, and you want to know the accessible population of each city, meaning how many people could easily get to a store in this city. So let's define accessible population as all the people that live in cities within 300 kilometers of this city. So these are people who could, you know, go for a long drive and get to your store. How are we going to find the accessible population of each city? You could launch a thread for each city and have it look at every other city. You get the idea. And then it could compute the distance to all those other cities. And if it's under 300 kilometers, then add the population of that other city to a running total. So in practice, most of these would be more than 300 kilometers away, and you just discard them. That would be really inefficient, right? You can imagine that having every city check every other city. I've only drawn 50 cities here. If I'd drawn, you know, the 2,000 or 3,000 or 10,000 cities that actually exist in the United States, this would quickly become way too much work. So instead, we could create a spatial data structure, such as overlaying, say, a 300-kilometer grid onto the map, and then creating a list of cities that fall into each grid cell. So this cell would be empty. This one would have three cities. This one would have 1, 2, 3, 4 cities. I think that one has three. This one has one, and so on. Right? So we could make a list of all of the cities that fall into each grid cell. And now, if you want to find all cities within 300 kilometers of a given city, say Denver here, you only need to look at the grid cell that that city falls in and the neighboring cells, right? So I need to check these three here. There's two cities so close together you can't even tell. That's Denver and Boulder. I need to check these cities. So I still have several checks to make, but this is still vastly fewer checks than I would have to make if I were checking all of the cities against all of the other cities. So by creating these grid cells, these bins that contain the cities, and therefore being able to restrict which sections, which bins I need to look in, I've drastically reduced the amount of work that I need to do to find this accessible population that I'm trying to figure out. So this is a great example of binning. So let's have a quiz. Which of the following operations would probably benefit from the geographic binning stage described above? Suppose that for all U.S. cities in the list, we wanted to compute a histogram of city distances from a central warehouse in Denver, Colorado. What if you had a list of roads, each of which was represented as a list of line segments, and you wanted to compute the population of cities within 20 kilometers of that road? Would it help to use the geographic binning that we described? Most U.S. cities are in geographic administrative divisions called counties. To give you a sense of what a county is, if you're not from the U.S., I've pulled out the Wikipedia map of U.S. counties, and I've zoomed in so you can see some of the counties in our states. And as you can see, there's thousands of counties. There's about 3,000 counties across the U.S. So given a list of counties and a list of cities, each of which contains an index to the containing county, the county that it's inside, what if you needed to compute the city-dwelling population of all counties? Would this geographic binning operation help?